In the previous video, I talked about why container orchestration engine is needed, why Kubernetes is needed. I answered that question. Now we're going to start talking about how it works. And in order to understand that, we need to set up an environment. So the first thing that you need to do is the reason why we need Kubernetes is we want to run containers on a group of servers. And instead of talking to each of that server independently, what we are trying to do with Kubernetes is we create a cluster out of that. So that's what Kubernetes does. So now we are not talking to the group of servers. We are talking to just one entity, that is Kubernetes. And behind it, it can be like four servers or 400 or 4,000. You can always keep on scaling up as you need it. In fact, Kubernetes today supports about 5,000 servers. Now, in order to understand Kubernetes practically, we need to create an environment with at least, let's say, 2 to 3 nodes and create a cluster out of that, and then start talking to that cluster and then move on with the new next concept. So I'm going to show you how to create a cluster on Google platform in this video. Here, I'm logged in to the Google console, the cloud console, that is cloud.google.com. And I already have a Google account, that is my Gmail account. And since I'm logged in with that, it already shows me my login on the top right corner. And the best part about this is it allows you to try Google Cloud for free, and it gives you $300 credits for 1 year, which is enough for you to run, keep running the Kubernetes cluster for months, which is great. So what I'm going to do is sign up to Google Cloud here by accepting the terms on the right hand side, choosing my country and the tax information and providing that information here. Trust me, this is the best way to get started with Kubernetes. This is the simplest way to create Kubernetes cluster because Google Cloud gives you a managed environment and you can set up the cluster like in like 5 minutes time. And once you're logged in, so what is also assumed is you have set up the billing services. If you have not, you have to do that and take the additional steps. Once you log in, you go to the top left corner, click on that menu, go to the Kubernetes engine. Here you will see a project as well. Project offers sort of an organization or a namespace, and this might take a few minutes for you to get activated, the Kubernetes container engine, once you click on it. So you might have to wait for a few minutes here. Come back after a few minutes, you will see that option activated. So you click on create cluster, and it's really simple to create a cluster. All you have to do is, even if you don't want to provide or choose any options, all you have to do is provide just a name for the cluster. Even if you don't do that, there are defaults. Even the configuration has defaults, including the region in which you want to set up that cluster. Google Cloud provides multiple regions, and you can pick the regions possibly closest to you or the one which is closest to your users. And then even if you don't do that, you can just choose everything default and just go ahead and click on create cluster. It also shows you the default pool. This is the actual node. So Google creates a bunch of nodes. Those are the virtual machines or servers on the Google platform. On top of that, it is going to set up your Kubernetes cluster. So these are the nodes where your containers would be running. And I've kept everything default, clicked on create, and it has started launching the cluster. Again, this is going to take a few minutes. So I'm going to skip forward and come back after the cluster has been created and then start with the rest of the configurations. So there I have it. So after a few minutes, I have my cluster running. I'll just give you a quick tour of this cluster. So if I click on the cluster name, it shows you the number of nodes, where it has been created, what are the endpoints, what are the IP addresses, what is the configuration. These are the default configurations for your cluster. It shows you the pool of nodes, which I have as 3. And collectively, it shows you the number of cores available for that cluster and the amount of memory. These are the 3 servers, VMs, which are created on Google Cloud compute engine. On top of that, the Kubernetes environment has been set up. So these are the actual nodes, and you see the number of amount of CPU available, as well as number of amount of CPU requested or being used, consumed mainly by the Kubernetes control plane, which is Kubernetes's own services. Now, if you look at show services, so if you go to the workload and show system services, you see these have been provisioned automatically by default while this Kubernetes managed environment has been launched. And these are the ones which are running on the nodes right now, including, let's say, Fluentd for collecting the logs. Heapster is a monitoring service. There is an autoscaler. There is a DNS service. There is a metric server and so on and so forth for monitoring and stuff like that, right? And since this is a managed service, we don't have a control over this. Google automatically sets up all of these. If you look at everything else, if you just explore the tabs, you won't find much right now. We have just created a cluster successfully. In the next video, I'm going to show you how to deploy an application on top of this cluster. Again, I'm going to do that completely through the Google console this time, which is the simplest way to get started and get an understanding of how Kubernetes works. And this is in a managed environment on Google Cloud Platform.